On a bar stool she took off her ring. I thought I'd get closer, so I walked on over. I sat down and asked her her name. When the drinks finally hit her, she said, I'm no quitter, but I finally quit living on dreams. I'm hungry for laughter and here ever after. I'm after whatever the other life brings. In the mirror I saw him and I closely watched him. I thought how he looked out of place. Came to the woman who sat there beside me. He had a strange look on his face. The big hands were calloused. He looked like a mountain. For a minute I thought I was dead. But he started shaking. His big heart was breaking. He turned to the woman and said, you picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille, with four hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times, lived through some sad times, but this time you're hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. I ordered more whiskey. I thought how she'd made him look small. From the lights of the bar room to a rented hotel room, we walked without talking at all. She was a beauty, but when she came to me, she must have thought I'd lost my mind. I couldn't hold her, 'cause the words that he told her kept coming back time after time. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucy, with four hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times, lived through some sad times, but this time you're hurting won't heal. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. You picked a fine time to leave me, Lucille. Four hungry children and a crop in the field. I've had some bad times, lived through some sad times, but this time you're hurting.
Dorina May, I'm going to do something real big for God.
You're finally going to go next door and talk to Andy?
Nope. Picture a 360-foot statue of Jesus in our backyard with a fish in one hand and a loaf of French bread in the other.
That's nice, Stu Bob.
Where's that sack of cement I had?
You mean the one you bought to engrave the entire Bible on?
Yeah, that's right.
It's next to the paint you were going to use for the mural of the Last Supper.
You don't think I'm gonna do this, do you?
Stu Bob, every time you get inspired, you want to do something so big that you just can't do it.
Well, these things take time.
Why don't you start by talking to Andy?
I don't want to touch just one person. I want to touch thousands.
No, you don't. You want to do anything you can but talk to your neighbor.
I know. I'll make Christian radio messages and play them on the radio.
That still ain't talking to your neighbor. Will you go next door?
Another message from Lifeline Productions, the comic strip of radio, at lifelinepro.com.